us. I think it was very well organized. They gave us a chance to come here, have a playoff type mentality, and still have a bowl experience. I think that the time that they accessed to do things was very short. It was very entertaining for our football players. It was great to spend some time with Coach Riley and his family, get to see the staff, get to see his fine football team. I thought our teams interacted well together. There were some competitive games and stuff. It was fun. The food's been great. The facility's been great. Just a great atmosphere. Both of them are ready to play, along with Chris Curry. All three of them have different talents. Clyde can do all three things. I think all three of them are different. All three of them can do some of the things that Clyde does, not all the things that they do. They've matured. I think the games have gotten them ready. John's improved on the things he had to improve on. Tyron's a big bull. He's very physical. Chris Curry has learned the offense and can go in there and give us a play. So I think all three of them have improved. But they have to play very well if they play against a very stiff Oklahoma defense.
All right, next, let's go right over.
He did a little more yesterday. He felt a little sore after he broke down. I talked to him last night. Obviously, if Clyde's ready to play, we're going to let him play. That's going to be a game-time decision. The trainers are going to let us know if he's able to play, first of all. Then I'm going to ask him, why are you ready to play? Knowing Clyde, he's going to want to play. Do I think he plays? Yeah. How much he plays, I don't know. We've got still a ways to go there. He's still a little sore. He's not 100% healthy, obviously. I don't know if he can cut yet. He doesn't know if he can cut yet. We'll see. Guys winning the Heisman, how they gonna play after and all that stuff. We made sure that Joe was resting. We made sure that we had blocked out all the noise. We haven't talked about any individual awards, accomplishments in our meeting, so I think we've left that stuff behind. And, we haven't talked about the pressures of the playoff game or nothing like this. We're gonna approach this game just like any other game. The only thing I told him, we'd come to playoff game, not a bowl. I do believe we're going to play loose. It's any indication of the way they've been all week. They've been loose all week. They've had great practices. I don't think that a pressure of a big-time game is going to get to these guys. They have great leadership. But we'll see. You never can tell until the game goes.
Right, next question. All right, right here, row three on the aisle, please.
That the transfer portal, in some situations, is very good. I do believe that. There's no question about that. If a player can transfer, is not playing at a school, and can transfer like both of these quarterbacks and go there and lead their team to a championship season, I think it's phenomenal. I think everybody needs that chance. I think if a player is going through some hard times and he just wants to quit and he's not wanting to persevere and he wants to take the easy way out, I think it's a bad thing for football. I think that everybody needs to stick to it. We've had some players that have transferred and have not had success. I think they wish they would still be on the football team. We've had some players on our football team that thought about transferring and have come back and they're glad that they stuck it out. In some situations, it's very good. I do believe that. There's no question about that. If a player can transfer, is not playing at a school, and can transfer like both of these quarterbacks and go there and lead their team to a championship season, I think it's phenomenal. I think everybody needs that chance. I think if a player is going through some hard times and he just wants to quit and he's not wanting to persevere and he wants to take the easy way out, I think it's a bad thing for football. I think that everybody needs to stick to it. We've had some players that have transferred and have not had success. I think they wish they would still be on the football team. We've had some players on our football team that thought about transferring and have come back and they're glad that they stuck it out. Support system that we have a lot of help with those issues. For that, we're very fortunate. When you have a guy like Kevin Falk that's around, that's able to talk to these guys on a daily basis, that helps. You recruit character, it helps. I do believe that the leadership leadership of this football team, the coaches that we have, and the character. You know, when we recruit, and I'm sure coaches the same way, character counts. You know, if there's any red flags, we're really looking at the football player and not bringing them in. I think that has changed our perception here at LSU. I think that we have guys that are great players, great character. I think that the daily process and the focus that we have on this football team has helped that.
I think it's helpful for a lot of our staff and players that have been here to understand the scope of it and all the attention and hype that comes around with this game. I think, personally for me, probably the biggest help is having gone through this a few different times is within the scheduling. You know, there's so much. You've got a lot of different choices on how you can handle this amount of time. And this year has been different than the others, you know, like we've said, you know, 1,000 times now because of being a week shorter. But it has helped us, you know, in some trial and error before. The playoffs have brought, you know, a lot of attention. I think you've got national champions out of it that are very deserving, and that's the end goal. Deep down, do I believe at some point we're going to have all the conference champions involved? It's hard to say no to that, just because conference championships at this level are so hard to win, and college football is different because leagues are different, and leagues are different year to year, and sometimes it's tough to compare, you know, one team's schedule or how one conference does it or how one conference sets up their conference championship game to other leagues. And so, you know, I do think we have a great product right now. I think we've got a great system, but a system down the road that maybe guaranteed all the conference champions in, I don't know that I would disagree with that.
I think it's good the way it is. Obviously, that's out of my wheelhouse. I don't have a vote. And if it goes to eight, stays at four, we just want to play.
Next question here, row two on the right.
I have Coach Robinson on my staff, obviously, so he's with me every day. That helps. I have Kevin Falk with me that's been with Belichick, so that helps. So anytime I don't even have to pick up the phone, I just need to walk down the hall and ask him a question. So that's very, very helpful to us. You know, I look into things that we did in Miami. I look into things that we did with Coach Carroll. If I have to call, I can call Coach Carroll and ask him a couple of questions. I don't. I still have the same practice plans that we used when we were back there, the same game plan. So every once in a while, I look at that, but more or less, I learned it. It's more or less those programs, the Miami program and the USC program is what we're doing today. I think we were a little surprised with all this quarterback. We knew he could run. We had a scheme that really, really got to us a little bit. We weren't as prepared for that scheme as we thought we'd be, and he was faster and they were better. I don't think this is going to be the case. That doesn't mean we're going to stop him. We know this guy's a great player. We know they have a great scheme. We know they make plays. And we're just not going to shut down this offense. You know what I mean? But we need to be in the right place at the right time. We need to play out box. We need to tackle in space. And we need to keep coming after it. This is going to be a war. This is going to be one of the hardest offensive we've tried to stop since I've been here at LSU, and Jalen's one of the best players. We know that. He's beat us twice already. So he has the ultimate respect, head coach here, and everybody on staff too.
It's been the year that we've had the most lineup changes, major injuries, guys out for games. We've dealt with that all season. So honestly, this is nothing new for us other than probably a little bit easier in the fact that you have had some time to plan for it. Our guys know the deal. You know, that's our culture there. It's if somebody's down for whatever reason, it's next man up. I don't think it's phased our team at all. We're used to it, and we've got confidence in the guys that will step up in that place. You know, a lot of attention, I think. You've got national champions out of it that are very deserving, and that's the end goal. Deep down, do I believe at some point we're going to have all the conference champions involved? It's hard to say no to that, just because conference championships at this level are so hard to win, and college football is different because leagues are different, and leagues are different year to year, and sometimes it's tough to compare, you know, one team's schedule or how one conference does it or how one conference sets up their conference championship game to other leagues. And so, you know, I do think we have a great product right now. I think we've got a great system, but a system down the road that maybe guaranteed all the conference champions in, I don't know that I would disagree with that.
I think it's good the way it is. Obviously, that's out of my wheelhouse. I don't have a vote. And if it goes to eight, stays at four, we just want to play.
Next question here, row two on the right.
Florida playing against them. It was one of those nights. We were playing great. We had our best game. A lot of respect for Oklahoma, obviously. Playing in the Orange Bowl, playing against a great player like Adrian Peterson. We had a lot of great players on that football team. That was probably one of Coach Carroll's best team. It was a tremendous night. I remember we won, we beat Oklahoma that night. And then the next morning, I had to drive to Orlando and catch a flight to go to Ole Miss to start at 3:30 in the morning. So I didn't get to enjoy it much, but I do remember it. And again, a lot of respect for Oklahoma and a lot of respect for Adrian Peterson.